Hi everyone, Sandy from Hobby Headquarters. Today we're going to be building the Dragon 1/35 scale Sdkfz 252. This is a munitions halftrack from World War II, and they would use these to transport the ammunition that would go along with the Sturmgeschütz. And you might remember, well, it's probably been close to about a year now, we built this early war Sturmgeschütz. And I thought this would be a perfect opportunity to add another vehicle to it, possibly even down the road build a little diorama with it. Now, this vehicle has a full interior, so we'll be taking advantage of that and building that all up in there as well. And it's about 400 parts in this kit, so not too crazy on the part count. We'll talk more about that once we get into the build. So let's get started on it. Before we get started on the build process, I thought I would take this opportunity to show you guys some wonderful books from Mr. Black Publications. He has a whole line of different types of books on dioramas, figures, all kinds of stuff like that. And just to show you some examples of this book right here, this book has got some great ideas for doing dioramas, doing the painting. But one thing that was very, very helpful on this one that I thought going forward, I'm not a excellent figure painter by any means, so I thought I wanted to get into it a little bit more to start doing some figures for the vehicles that I produce to show you guys. And there's some great articles in here about doing eyes and the step-by-step process for doing a face to the point where, turn the page here, you can see at the very end that some of these pictures don't look like a real human being, not a scale model. Just some wonderful work and lots of color photos in here. It's just great work all the way around. Plus, like I said, they also have some ones on doing some dioramas. So they've got all kinds of diorama stuff inside. The vehicles, figures, things like that. What I'll go ahead and do is I'll put up the link that if you guys want to order any of his books from him. They're out of Greece, but he ships worldwide. So what I'll do is I'll put that right down on the bottom right now. And by all means, check these out. These are some really high quality publications that I've been spending the last couple of... last week going through all of it. Got some really good ideas, all that. So check them out. Okay, as we start gluing some of the parts together, first thing I'll point out to you too is this is a new lower hull as well as an upper too because of the type of shape it is. And Dragons went and retooled the entire lower hull here to make it a bathtub style hull. In fact, you use a few parts for the front axle and it's on the tree that has the old hull on it, which a little bit of a pain sometimes putting those parts together, so very impressed with the quality of the new hull on it. Also, there's quite a few road wheels that are very highly detailed, as well as the drive sprocket, which is made up of three individual pieces that build up really nicely. One thing I did on this right here, and it's just a helpful thing because as you're doing all the sanding on all these road wheels, it's good to put them into separate piles. That way you don't confuse any of them going forward because a lot of them look very similar, but they won't fit properly. You won't totally not be able to do it later on. It's just going to make it quicker going together knowing where all the wheel parts are. Okay, as we speed through the construction process of putting on the suspension arms, just to point out to you too that all the suspension arms can only go on one way because they have indicator pins on it that only allow it to go on that way. So you won't have to worry about messing that up. Okay, I've got one side of the tracks done at least. Had no problems. It's a little time consuming because of how tiny the parts are, but they go together nicely and they do that nice feature of having it work together. And because the tracks do work together, I started looking ahead a little bit in the instructions, and I think we can still paint the road wheels pretty easily here. What I've done is I've only glued the outer road wheel these two right into place. The rest of these are kind of just sitting there, so that way we can get in there, do our base coat painting of the entire model, and still get back in there and paint the rubber around it easy enough because they still spin. So I've gone ahead and attached all of those parts. I've left the drive sprocket so loose again, so it just sometimes it's a little bit easier to get the tracks on when you can have just a little bit of play in it. So what we'll do now is I've got all the sub-assemblies ready to go for the interior of the vehicle. And we put some of these things in. Well, we're going to go ahead and, of course, paint all these in a little while as well. And we'll come show glue them down. But this is basically just to show you how everything fits in here very nicely. We've got all the little seats and things like that. And then the transmission will plug right into here. And then they also have an engine as well that we built up. That doesn't get called out to get put in for a little while, but just kind of show you where it's going to go inside here. And you can see how that we're going to get a nice little interior on this. So what I'll do now is I'm going to go ahead and glue the chairs and all the other parts together on that. And then I'll show you how the sides go on next. I was just playing around with putting on the sides and find that there's a little tab in the front, and the fit is very, very nice on that. In fact, it kind of just plugs right into shape. Now, obviously, we do have to glue it down. What I'm going to do first is there's some radios and some other side pieces that go in here on both sides. But construction-wise, it should be very simple. You can see how it all lines right up in there. We will glue that down and get all the other parts on there and come back and mate the top to it. Okay, I've glued a couple of the other extra little parts on, as well as gluing the engine down. Now I've got the side fenders here that we've glued on a couple of the little parts. I left purposely all the tools off because we're going to glue those on later. I was just dry fitting these a few minutes ago and get it to line up here. You can see it just clicks right into place, real tight fit, actually both sides too. So we'll go ahead and glue both of these down. And based on the way the instructions are saying, you can see how that all fits on there. We also have the front piece here too that I got to do a little more sanding on, but we'll glue that into place as well. So far, very, very good fit. Nice tight areas, no gaps or anything that need to be filled. And what I'll do after I get these fenders glued into place, we're going to probably go ahead and start painting the interior portion of this vehicle before, because I believe the next couple of steps are going to require us to glue the top on. So it'll be much easier, obviously, gluing it on before we do any other work. So let's get these fenders on and I'll start painting inside. This is a quick little builder's tip as well. As you go to glue this front armor plate on, it's best to put the actual top of the body on there too. That way you get all of this lined up correctly. Don't glue it into place, just hold it down. Get this part glued on, and then you can just pull this away. And this way, this armor plate up front will be in the exact right spot it's supposed to be. I was just about to go paint the vehicle, and I figured I was going to paint the tracks at the same time. So I was going to do a little dry fitting on there, and it's definitely a good idea to leave this drive sprocket off, because this way you can wrap it around, plug the tracks in right above, get those wrapped around, and then you can pin them together. Because without taking this drive sprocket off, it's very difficult getting the tracks on. So definitely do not glue those into place. So we're going to go ahead now and paint the interior, part of the exterior, and we'll also paint up all the tracks as well right now. Okay, I want to show you guys what I've done on the vehicle so far. As you saw earlier, we painted the inside of the fighting compartment as well as the engine compartment. I did go over it with some Tamiya panel liner and just did some light washes inside there. It didn't go crazy with the detail because once this goes on, I did leave one of the hatches open for it, but you're not going to be able to see a heck of a lot inside. So, and then as it goes for the top section of the hull, we've put the photo etch in for the grills, which are all included, all the lifting hooks, Like I told you, left one of these open just so we could probably put a commander figure inside and also put all the lights and things like that on. So the next step that we'll go on this will probably be gluing this top piece down, getting that to fit in the shape. We have all of the tracks built, ready to go. The way I was telling you earlier is how we're gonna do this is we're gonna paint the tracks, paint this drive sprocket separately. We'll wrap the tracks around the drive sprocket. That way we get a nice, no color bleed over on it. And then we'll glue this right into place on the actual vehicle. Now, before we start doing any more painting, I do have to build the ammo trailer that is included with this. And I've begun cutting and sanding that out right now. So what I'll do now is I'll show you the build of that. And then we'll come back and start our painting. Okay, to start out, there are two of the same part molded, and the difference between a light right and a left is by where you drill your holes out. So keep that in mind as you start your assembly process so you don't get the two confused. And then on the other side, all you have to do is notch this little piece out right here. And you just got to make sure you, like I said, keep those in order so then both notches turn up on the same side to put the undercarriage in. So we'll glue those two portions up together, and then I'll just show you the rest of it kind of like fast forward how it all goes together. Also want to drop in all of these parts down in here, the bottom floor, and this will keep everything nice and square. And then dropping the ammunition rack inside of that. And even if you decide you're not going to open up the top of this to show the ammunition, it's a good idea to put that in there because it adds a lot of rigidity to the piece. Then as we flip it over, these are those little notches that we had to cut out. And you'll see how this just pops right into shape here. And this is your axle for the piece. So we'll go ahead and glue that in there nice and tight and start putting the rest of the parts on it. Lastly, I have all the little sub-assemblies for the trailer ready to go together. We are going to leave the tools off because we're going to paint those separately. And one other quick little builder's note that I'll give you as I was starting to build. When you start putting the fenders together, make sure you keep in mind too these little tabs that they go on the right side. So when you're putting the light and some of the other pieces on the back, make sure they all go on the right side of it. I think I'm going to leave the wheels off of this portion of the build, just so it'll be easier to paint those separately, and then we can go ahead and glue them on later. But we'll get all the fenders, oops. We'll get all the fenders on. Now I've decided to leave at least one of the doors open on the trailer. So we'll close probably this side down, and then we'll leave the side with some of the ammunition sticking out on it. Now it does come with some photo etch pieces that are the primer caps on the end here, but we will glue those on last because we don't want to have to paint over them. They would probably be brass. So we'll glue these into place right here, get all the other little pieces on, and then also, before we go any further, and while we're doing, I just put a little tiny bit of putty on one part of this portion of the upper and lower body hull construction. It fit pretty good. There was just a little tiny seam, which I even have a tiny bit right here. We've got to do a little sanding on, but overall the fit was pretty good. So this portion of it is all, after we sand it and fill that seam a little bit more, we'll be all ready to start painting. And then let's let this dry a little bit more, and then we'll start our painting process. Okay, we've gone over the NATO black with a little white to kind of blend in the paint so it's not all one stark color. And now we're going to use XF63, the German gray, to go over the entire vehicle. Okay, let me show you guys what we've done so far. I went ahead and painted the tracks with our track color, which is 70% NATO brown and 30% NATO black, and did all the entire tracks, but then went back over all of the rubber pads inside there and painted those with the black, or NATO black actually. And then we took a little bit of our paint retarder, mixed it up, and did all of the rubber around the road wheels as well as the front tires as well. After that was all dry, we completely sprayed the entire thing with Tamiya's TS80, which is this right here, the flat clear. I find that does a really nice job of a nice smooth coat on the vehicle. What we're going to do now is I've been painting the tools off camera, so we'll start putting those on fairly soon, but we're going to go ahead and start putting some of the decals on now. And we're going to try to make it as close of a match to our Sturmgeschütz as possible, so they look like they're part of the same time period. And to make sure that the decals are not going to have any of the silvering effect underneath here, we're going to make sure all the air bubbles out. So we put a little tiny touch of the Mark Fit Strong across the top there. We're going to let that soak in for just a little bit, and then going over it with a cotton swab, burnish it down to make sure the decal is really, really tight. Then after that is all done, we're going to go ahead and spray the entire thing with dull coat, but not the TS80 this time, because that says right on the label there that it can eat decals. So we'll just use some Testers 1260 dull coat. Just finished up painting the handles on the for all the tools, and what we did for that was we used XF59, the desert yellow. Sorry about the streak down the front there. Just painted them regular, but then after that we went over it with Tamiya's panel line brown, and you can see how it gives it the little streak effect of like wood grain and like dirtiness on the wood. So we're gonna finish up doing all those handles, finish up the decals, and start applying the tools. Okay, right now I'm in the process of doing some highlights on the German gray, which hopefully you guys can see pretty well on camera here. And what I've done for that is I've taken a mixture of 50% XF63, 50% XF19, mixed them together to get kind of a lighter color gray, but a gray that matches the tone that we already have. And then I put 5 drops of Tamiya's paint retarder inside of there. And this just helps a lot more for the blending process as we go over it. So I've done this side, and you can see how a lot of the things start to pop out a lot better. But I'll show you a little bit on this side. This is just going to be some good old-fashioned dry brushing, putting a little bit of the paint in there, and because of the paint retarder, the paint dries very, very slowly. So we put a little bit on the brush and then try to take as much as possible off, and then hopefully we got enough off here. Start on the road wheels and then just lightly start to go over there, and you can just see how stuff starts to pop right out. We'll start doing you want to kind of go in a random motion from time to time to blend everything together. And you really want to put as little paint as possible on the brush. And just let it build up gradually. And this is a process too that could take, you know, a couple applications till you get it to the way you want. The thing is you want to build them up slowly, because if you accidentally get any on too heavy, you're going back over it and repainting it with the German gray. And this just really makes things pop right out. So you get the idea of what I'm talking about now on that. Like I said, this side's done a little bit more already. So what we'll do is I'm going to go over the rest of the vehicle and really highlight everything. And we'll come back and do the next step. Okay, now that we've put our highlight coat on and let that dry, we're going to be using the same color that we used for the tracks, which was 70% NATO brown, 30% NATO black. And we've added a little bit of the paint retarder to it. And that's just to slow the drying time down. So as we're going to go on, we're going to take a fine tip brush, and we're just going to put a few little chips and some fine scratches on the upper portions of the vehicle. Give it kind of a used effect that guys have actually been on this and dragging equipment off, things like that. And this is a little slow process because you don't want to put too much on at once. You can put some individual scratches in here too, real fine ones. But you need very, very little paint on the brush. And hit any of the areas that look like would get some rub marks on it. So hopefully you can see that pretty well on camera there. So what I'm going to do is, I'm going to do this, spend a little bit of time putting some minor scratches over the whole vehicle. Remember now, we still haven't put any of the tools on. And it's just good to do the tools last, because that way we're not trying to paint around them or any of those other pieces. So let's go ahead and finish that up. We'll come right back. Now, the vehicle is pretty much done, I will call it, for build-wise. But you'll right away, you'll notice, obviously, the blue masking tape that I've put over these little areas where all of the markings are. What we're going to do now is we're going to spray the entire model, or at least the upper portions of the model, with hairspray. And the reason we're going to be doing that is we're going to be doing this in a winter camouflage. So the way we're going to do it is we're going to spray the top with hairspray, let that fully dry, and then we're going to hit it with a little Tamiya XF2 in different areas, and we'll show how that goes on. And then we'll be able to scrape it off and make it look like a winter whitewash scene. Now, I'm not going to do the hairspray by spray on the lower portions, but I did spray a little bit of it into a bottle, or a little bottle cap, I should say, that we'll take a paintbrush and kind of blot it on, because I don't want to get too much of it on the tires and on the tracks. I kind of want to leave those the same. So I'm going to go ahead and spray it with hairspray right now, and then I'll come back and I'll show you putting the white paint on. Okay, you can see now that the hairspray is dried how shiny the surface is. And that's not to worry about that. We're going to dull coat after we've done the white and after we've taken it all off and we're ready for it. So let's go ahead and put some white on it now. After everything dried, we clear coated the entire model with TS-80, Tamiya's flat clear. Also applied all of the tools and a few little tarps and packs all around the outside edges of it. Now what we're going to do is we're going to start using some of the Tamiya panel line black and brown, as well as a little streaking grime, and start dirtying up the sides a little bit. We're going to be putting a little bit on and then just streaking down from top to bottom. Okay, here is our completed model. I'll kind of give you a little 360 of the kit. Construction wise, the kit fit together very well. There was only a few little minor little things that take a little putty here and there, but overall very easy to put together. The tracks, of course, are small, but look really good once they're all built up because of the type of construction they are. So I want to thank you guys as always for watching, and please stay tuned because we have more videos coming.